Crazy! Maybe this will remind you how to behave.
Into you sick, crazy bastards or what Uncle's done to you, but I'm going to get help. Stay calm. As calm as you can, seeing as both of you seem to have gotten a little excited. Probably just a fever. Jack, be kind to your mother. Abigail, teach the boy right from wrong. Both of you, stop biting chunks out of people. Be back as soon as I can. Guess I best go find me a doctor in town. Something don't feel right here.
Marston, sir! Marston! It's me!
Professor, what are you doing here? I thought you went back to Yale.
Well, I did, but I came back for another round of research, and now all hell is quite literally broken loose.
What is going on?
Well, sir, I am a man of science, a man of great learning, a thinker, a wise man, and I'll be honest with you, sir, I haven't got a fucking clue.
Well, ain't that dandy?
What should we do?
Well, I suggest we try to find other survivors, band together, and find a cure. Or fight to the death trying.
Well, that sounds great and all, but I'm just peachy. But I'm not sure that I'm cut out for such shenanigans. I was thinking more that finding a horse and riding back to the civilized north at the speed of knots before writing a paper on the events from the comfort of my study. I'm a scientist after all, right? I mean, I can't do much science if I'm some bloodshot dervish's lunch, can I? Much as I would like.
Your sense of duty is very impressive, Professor. I'm gonna search the back street for survivors.
No. Perhaps staying with you would be safer. Could you just wait a sec here, would you please? I'm going to wander down that lonely, deserted street and get my bag.
Wait, you should stay with me, Professor. You haven't got a gun.
Oh, no, it's okay. There's no need to worry. Everyone's already dead. I left my stuff with Mr. Nastas. You remember him. Indian fellow, dumb as bricks, but a good sort.
Okay. Well, meet me in a couple minutes.
Affirmative. A couple of minutes.
Anyone here? Hello? Anyone here?
In here, mister.
Come out. It's okay. Come out. I don't bite. Bad joke. I mean, come out.
They got my family, mister.
And mine, I fear.
I saw my mama rip my daddy's face off and drink his blood. And they were happily married 20 years.
I'm sorry.
We were so glad to see my mama. Because she's been dead for 3 years from the smallpox.
Your mama was dead?
I saw her walk up onto the porch. And then boom! She ate my daddy. You weren't a bad man, mister. You weren't. Sure, he liked to drink, but he weren't bad. And sure, he lacked the company of women, but he weren't bad, mister. He weren't.
No one deserves to have their blood drunk.
I mean, he knew how to use his fist. And if a woman spoke out of her place, he reminded her of it and everything. And when my mama was dying, people said that he was lying with her sister. But that weren't true, mister. It weren't.
But you said your mother was dead.
Yeah, her and Mr. Braithwaite. He's been dead a year. And then yesterday, he walked up that street eating dogs. And he loves animals. All the dead folk have come back to life, mister. Only they ain't happy. It's a funny kind of salvation.
All the dead folk?
All the folk buried at the cemetery over by the churchyard.
My God. I'm gonna go have a look. You wanna come?
No, I already seen my mama. I don't need to see any more of my relatives. Here, mister, take this. If you can burn them, maybe you can put their souls to rest. Aye, mister! You see my Uncle Mordecai? You burn him. Burn him real good, you hear?
How do you like that? That didn't go well. Come on, come on!
Thank you.
Consider yourself cured.
Trying to eat me.
That's unfortunate. I don't believe it. That'll do. Folks okay?
Oh, just fantastic. I just saw my daughter get eaten by some creature sent straight from hell. Thanks for asking.
I'm kind of sorry I did.
Sorry, mister. Forgive my wife. We've suffered terribly.
What's going on?
Well, it's the government's fault.
Ain't it always?
Well, they let in too many foreigners. Just shut the goddamn border or things like this happen. My daughter was just some satanic demon's lunch because of the goddamn government. And I pay my taxes. Well, usually.
I think we may be moving a little off topic here. I ain't a wise man, but I have done a little traveling. These creatures ain't like any foreigners I've ever seen.
Thanks for the input, cowpoke. Oh, I got flesh-eating monsters feasting on my family, and I'm taking advice about tolerance from a gunslinger. What in the world has my life come to? And my daddy told me I never should have gotten married. This is all your fault, you useless man!
Oh, not now, Doreen. Not this again. Your daddy was a bully and a drunk.
Well, you ain't no kind of man!
Listen! I'm sorry to interrupt your happy reminiscences. Is there anything I can do to help? Have you got any idea of how we can survive?
You could try shooting them creatures, you dumb fool.
Ma'am, it's been a real pleasure. Sir, you're a man of great patience.
See? That feller ain't hiding away like a little girl who's wet herself.
I thought we agreed we should stick together.
So we're just gonna stay up here till we either starve or have to eat each other?
What do you want me to do? I ain't God!
That surely you ain't! Oh, you're as useless as a poor car.
Hey, you one of them, mister?
Do I look like one of them?
Well, don't come no closer. We made that mistake before, lost half our number.
I ain't one of them, you fool.
Well, how do I know?
They can't speak.
Well, I ain't taking no chances.
Kill him, he's one of them!
Yeah.
No, I ain't!
Don't take no chances, Silas.
Have it your way, all right? Listen, I ain't coming no closer. Do you know what's going on?
It's the glass eye. The freak with the glass eye. He caused this.
No. It's the snake oil man. These poor folks have been drugged.
I blame the Mexicans. They haven't been struck down.
All right, we heard a lot of stories, mister. Some say it's a moon. Some say it's drugs. Hey, don't come no closer now. Stand back. Apparently it's worse in New Austin. Must be where it came from.
And it looks like I'm headed down to New Austin. Did one of you say snake oil?
It's the glass eye.
I blame the Mexicans.
Oh, Connie McTavish, you don't know nothing. You always was an ignorant shrew. I bet your husband's glad he's dead.
Well, at least my husband never took favors from the stargazers, Lucille Billingsgate.
You say you're sorry, you hillbilly white trash!
Yeah, now how are we gonna rebuild America like this? Now see, I thought we had it all decided. We was gonna be kind and gentle and pay homage to our leader, who happens to be me.
Sounds like you folks have this all worked out. Have yourself a fine America, and good luck.
We never had that decided. We decided we would hold elections and that I would be leader.
You can't even read.
Well, I got gravity. I mean, gravy. I mean, folk respect me.
I am the new king, Archibald Andrews. Me. Now pay him.
What is going on? I can honestly say I'm putting you out of your misery. Damn it! Let's go! try and help you out. Now you're talking.
Mister, hey, I got one.
Got what, mister?
The damn Sasquatch. The filthy thing was gonna eat my dog when this girl hollered out, and I shot the thing right through the heart. Boom, like that!
You feeling all right, mister? I've seen a lot of strange things recently, but no Sasquatch running around here, nor no place else. They're made up.
There's Sasquatches every place, cowboy. They're nastier than your mother-in-law with a bad case of that virus. Down in Manzanita Post, they ate a little girl.
Are you serious?
Do I look like I'm joking? The hills are infested with them. Kill them! Kill the bastards before they kill all of us! Kill them! Kill them! I ain't afraid of you, you dumb hairy bastards!
Thank you. Let's go! Go!
Shoot me, human! Shoot me!
Oh, I will, you foul creature of the night.
You'd be granting me peace.
Why's that? Keep you from eating more babies?
What in the name of all that's right are you talking about, human?
You eat babies. You have to survive. Everyone knows that. Ain't your fault.
We eat berries and mushrooms, you fool! But we did. Now none of us are left. Some maniac's been murdering us. I'm the last of my kind. We've lived in these hills 1,000 years.
You eat babies.
If you say so, human. My family is gone. My kind is gone. Shoot me. I can't take it anymore. Make it stop.
Come on! again.
My back, I'll claw it yours. God damn it! I knew it! What the hell is this?
here.
Didn't go well.
Come on. Please don't spit on me.
I knew it! Damn it to hell!
Oh!
world.
Sorry, lady, about how things turned out. Abigail, Jack, things I'd do for you. I'll take that.
A lot of kind of you.
This is something I don't want to think about. Come on! I knew this was a waste of time. God damn it!
Thank you.
ain't gonna beat this curse if we don't band together. Careful, lady. Come!
Seth, you okay? What's going on?
Oh, hey there, John. Fancy a game of cards?
Not right this minute.
You remember Moses, John?
He's
a darn sight more loyal now than he was before. come here, boy. Come on. Come here, boy.
What are you doing?
We were boyhood friends, John. Moses is having a tough time right now.
Ain't you, pal?
What's going on?
We're playing cards. Relax, sit down.
I mean, with the undead walking the face of the earth, you crazy dumb bastard.
That ain't nothing.
Ain't nothing? I seen husbands eating wives. Mothers eating sons. Graves popping open and the undead rising up. It sure as shit is something.
Oh, boo-hoo. Big tough John Marston is scared of a little undead creature walking around. Moses wouldn't hurt a fly, would you, darling? Besides, this ain't nothing new.
Folks in Blackwater blaming it on that glass eye you found.
Folks! 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 Damn them folks, John Marston! Damn them! And damn you! Get him! Get him, Moses! Get him!
After all I've done for you, Seth, and I thought loyalty was important to you.
You can't hurt me. Moses, get him! Go!
Yeah.
Get him!
Get me, Moses. Looks like your dog's lost his bite, Seth. Now what the hell's going on?
The dead have risen, and a virulent plague is turning people into flesh-eating crazies. What the hell you think's going on, genius?
But why?
But why? 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 Why not? Why not? Why the hell not?
'Cause it ain't natural.
Who made you Mother Nature and Mother Superior all at the same time? Who made you, John Marston? Same as made me, same as made Moses.
Is there a cure?
These things tend to fade away. Now, if you want to get rid of it, you should go clear the graveyards. Either that, or stop worrying and become one of them. Now, if you excuse us, we got good times to remember. Happy times.
Okay. See you soon then, Seth.
Come on, Moses. It's your deal. Diamonds are trumps. Come on.
What did you say? I'm starting to think you're still sweet on me, Mr. Ford.
Come on, join us. They don't bite. You look a little pale. Are you feeling all right, my dear? What an appetite, my angel. I'm starting to think you might have a tapeworm.
It's just me and you, partner!
It's every man for himself.
Shithole!
my day. Come on. Please don't spit on me.
You turn up. Could my week get any worse?
Oh, nice to see you too, Miss McFarlane.
Oh, I thought you'd be dead. I heard things were bad in West Elizabeth.
Sure. But it'll take more than an apocalypse to take me down.
What are you? A demon or a cockroach?
Both, I fear. How's your father?
Fine and dandy. He should be coming out of that barn any moment now. Daddy!
What's he doing in the barn?
Daddy, John's here! Mr. Marston, you remember? That idiot bounty hunter.
What was he doing in the barn?
Just rounding up the undead and keeping them safe so the rest of us can go about our business. He's a real man. He's probably playing around with him. Daddy, stop teasing me! Now, come on now!
How long's he been in there?
Not long. Only since yesterday.
Yesterday? I better go have a look for him.
Would you, John? You are kind. Call out to me if you find anything.
I will do.
Get this thing off of me! Goddamn animal!
down a little. Hold still, you ugly bastard.
Well, John, you always do bring sunshine to my life.
I'm sorry about your father.
I'd like to say he died doing what he loved. But he never was one for eating folks, not slathering from the lips and howling at the moon. I guess I'll content myself with saying that he died protecting those he loved.
Indeed.
Well?
Take care of yourself, Bonnie.
You too, John.
Let's go!
Come on. Welcome to paradise.
Hello, Marshal.
Glad to know you'd survive.
What's going on?
Do I look like I commune with the undead?
I don't know.
Well, then how would I know? My job is
to take care of the folk who live here.
Heard that.
How's that going?
How's that going? Well, let me put it to you this way. Cattle rustling, bank robbery are at all-time low. Murder, blood drinking, and psychotic episodes seem to be somewhat prevalent. Either that, or I'm dreaming.
That's what I'm hoping, too.
How was it getting in here?
It was crazy.
Must be hiding again. They come in and then just disappear. Town's been nearly overrun a couple of times. Now we're low on ammunition, and I'm two men down.
I'll help you clear the place out if you like.
You're a good man, John Marston. Before that, I'm gonna need my deputies back.
What happened to them two clowns you had before? Gone?
Maybe. I sent Jonah off to look for Eli. They both have been gone for several hours now.
Who'd want to eat one of them?
That's a good question.
Where'd you send
them? Out near the general store. Jonah's got one of these new guns. I'm sure he can't run it in any trouble. These things, they stop and help.
Thank you.
Thank you. I'm sure you got your own trouble.
That'll do. Hey, mister.
Hey, Pard.
You seen a couple deputies nearby? Marshall's boys, Jonah and Eli.
Are they Jews, mister? They sound like Jews.
I don't know. Why?
Why? This whole thing is nothing but a Jewish plot. You do know that, don't you?
I find that highly unlikely, amigo.
Well, I don't like Jews. Or colored folk. Or natives, now that you mention it.
Well, you're a nice, kind-hearted man to meet in a time of trouble.
Kind does not come into it.
Why? What are you talking about?
Why? I bet you like Catholics. I can't stand them neither. Nor women. Fabians, socialists, homosexuals, Asians, or British. Between them, they've ruined this country. Ruined it! It was a good country once! Now people are eating each other, and it's all the fault of the Jewish, British, Catholic, homosexual elite and their ideas. Well, I, for one, won't stand for it.
Have you ever met a Jewish person?
Thankfully not.
Or a British, Catholic, homosexual?
Not in my store. Oh, I get it. I see you acting clever. Well, let me tell you this. The Jews killed Lincoln. That's why there is a triangle on the money. And they run Europe like one of them Arabian harems. Now they've sent this here plague to kill all of... decent folk. Yep.
You, sir, are truly a remarkable fella.
Thank you kindly.
I must say, it's a rare pleasure to meet someone with such a grasp on human history. You take care of yourself. I'd hate to see you get savaged by someone and watch the life force drain from your hate-filled body.
Hey, hold on there. Why don't you join me in my fight, sir? It's not too late.
I fear it is for me.
Then I will fight them alone. All of them. America is the land of the free. And that means free to people like me, Herbert Moon.
Absolutely.
No! Oh, no, no! No!
Thank you.
corpse away from me!
Hello, boys. Marshall sent me, needs some help. Guess you got other plans. Seriously. Enjoy your meal, no problem. Easy now, gentlemen. Remember all the fun times we had? Not bad. Never seen you two move so fast.